everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Huskies are ranked number one here in the early stages of the season, but there is a long way to go before they can start thinking about playing for a national championship. The emphasis now, get better, get better. That's what the coaches keep telling them. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
We're in Husky Stadium in Seattle, Washington, and we are looking forward to bringing you a great matchup today. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He'll return it from the six. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Throws a strike over the middle, and down he goes around the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Three down, three down. Mike 51, Mike 51.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at about the 49.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Looks left, finding his tailback. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 48. And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. Completion.
Whoa, this play is predicated by the blitz of the defense. Offensive line did a nice job up front, and the quarterback made a great read and a heck of a throw connecting with his deep target.
From the 6-yard line, first down. At about the 3-yard line.
Definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The Utes were ranked number two, and after that performance, everyone knows why. If I were the losing coach in this one, I'd stay off the message boards. There are going to be people wanting this coach far, F-A-H-R-E-D. That means, like, really, really fired. And for Barnes, a terrific day. More than 300 yards passing. The Utes thrashed them and take the big victory.
Griffin looks ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And he's tackled at the 27. Kent's taking the field for the first time. Kirk, you've had this feeling. It's something special when you're at home.
It's amazing to watch certain players when they play at home and how they can have an impact on not just their own offense, maybe even their defense, the coaching staff, but the entire stadium. We've seen that over the years. Guys like Cam Newton at Auburn, or going back to Tim Tebow when he was playing at Florida. I think we're seeing the same kind of thing with this young man.
The Huskies always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. Big opening. He's tackled at the 46. Pitch it. Pickup of about 6 yards on the pitch to the halfback.
That brings him second and five.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Taken down at the 32-yard line.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Quick out to his receiver. And he's tackled around the 17-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17. Brought down at the 16-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Bring him down in the backfield.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tries to set up a screen for the wide receiver. He's pushed out of bounds at the 14.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
Fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. The kick is up, and he got it. Washington lines up for the kickoff. Williams from the 7. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. Illinois' offense deserves all the credit in the world. You come into a crowd like this, and they didn't keep them from doing the job at hand. They got points on that opening march.
Just really impressive. Considering this is, I think, one of the toughest environments in all of college football, that's a job well done. Now they've got to continue to try to build off of that opening drive.
Illinois is up 4. And they make the stop at the 23-yard line.
That was just smash-mouth, helmet-to-chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
from their own 23-yard line. It's second down. Pitch out left, and he'll go down short of the line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry.
I don't know what game plan this offense is running. It might need to be reassessed by this coaching staff.
Robertson is the punter. And he has it on the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he carries the ball for a nice game. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Throws incomplete. Big opening. And he tackles him hard at the 13-yard line. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. He fights forward to about the 10. And the quarterback picks up about 3 on the draw. That'll make it 7-7. Fires out quick. It's picked off. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Three down.
Illinois holds a 4-point lead. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. The Fighting Illini lead 7-3. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. Washington was the intended target on the play. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Little handoff. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. That makes it second. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. They'll work the left, and they'll get him in the backfield.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they were hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit. They held him short.
Washington is back to receive. He's to the 40. Tackle at the 42-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Illinois is up by four. He fights forward to about the 43. A yard, if any, there for the halfback. That brings up second and nine. From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. Down he goes at the 43-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
He steps out to 39-yard line. That makes it second and six. From the 39-yard line, second down. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Looks to him again, complete. Tackle made around the 24-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Three down. 51, Mike 51.
He gets rid of this one.
Man left. Three down.
Illinois is up four. They bring him down.
Perfect time to call the blitz. He took a bit of a chance, but it paid off by the linebacker being able to get through there, shoot the gap, and get to the quarterback.
So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. They'll bring him down at the 19. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. this one off. And he'll return this one from the 7. Brought down at the 31.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
He airs it out.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver. But it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Slings it, and he's taken down at the 24-yard line. And he's immediately tackled. It's first and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line. So they're back in the red zone where they threw a pick on their last visit. On the run. Tackle at the 14-yard line.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Check, 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 check. My gate, my gate.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts.
Set. Ready.
Three, three, three.
Got him on the screen play. He's tackled around the 8-yard line.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Now it's 3rd and 6 coming up. Ball on the 8-yard line. Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. Play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds the extra point. A 6-play, 68-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
This one's all even at 10. Walton gets set to kick this one away. Williams takes it at the 4. And he has it on the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 33-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Run up the middle.
With the tackle. Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
So it's 2nd down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's taken down to 47.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. First down.
He fires left side. And he's tackled around the 18-yard line. Big gain there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big gain.
So let's see how the defense runs now. It's 1st down and 10. Makes it out to about the 10. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. Illinois is going to have to use their 2nd time out of the half.
Three down, three down. Mike 51, Mike 51.
Ready, five. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards.
That makes it first. It's first down. They'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Fighting Illini.
Oh, that's a great job of some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
And he converts the extra point. It was a six-play, 68-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. So the score now, 17-10. Griffin has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Tidwell from the 8. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 39. Kent's play at quarterback has been kind of what we expected. He's one of the best in the country. The only problem is they're lacking in some other areas right now.
Well, I think this offense is doing everything that they can to be able to win this game, but that's why it's a team sport. The offense and this quarterback, you expect so many great things from, they can only do so much. And eventually, the defense and the entire group, they're going to have to play well if they want to get out of here with a victory.
Throws a bullet. That's incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
2nd and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. Brought down at the 47-yard line. Five wide. And they make the stop at about the 45.
Good, solid defense there to force them into a fourth down situation.
And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Illinois is up a score. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. It's 2nd down and 8. Ball on the 26-yard line. He is drilled at the 26, and the halfback's got nowhere to go. Washington's going to use their first time out of the half here. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
They're going to come up short here on this third down. The defensive line did a great job of getting some penetration, and the overall defensive effort was big there to set up this fourth down.
Robertson is the punter. Tidwell fields it at the 38, gets to about the 47-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He goes downtown. And he's got it, touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So at the end of the half, this game is all tied up 17. Hi,
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both teams wanted number
eight. Well, we welcome you back to the action. Just about set to start the second half in a tie ball game. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. He's got the corner. And he's taken down at the 39. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Got it and brought down immediately. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He heaves it to the end zone. He's in. Touchdown, Washington.
He's a nightmare to try and cover, and he showed you why right there. His speed just melts coverage schemes.
The PAT. Washington is lining up to kick this one off. Washington from the six. Washington's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure, but they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
It's on the ground, picks up the fumble,
and down he goes, right around the 30. That mistake will cost this offense possession of the ball.
And this young safety was right there to pick up the fumble. Huge break for the defense. When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, uh-oh, we can't let him get another one so quickly.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the call on the field stands. Washington is up by a touchdown.
Three down, three down. Mike five.
Let's go.
Takes it right. Oh, what a hit.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
From the 30-yard line, second down.
Drop deep, drop deep. Mike eight, Mike eight.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. And he just gets rid of it. Makes the PAT. So a short three-play, 30-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 31-17. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. Second and seven. Ball on the 27. Tackle made right around the 28-yard line. So the option keeper goes for about a yard.
That'll make it 35.
They come out on an empty backfield. He's got it with room to run. He's to the 40. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. Almost picked off.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Gives it to the back. And he's taken down at about the 43-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Gets it. He's in space. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line.
Tempted with the tackle at the 48-yard line. First down.
Tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. They lose 3 yards there.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
This is the eighth play of this drive. He's under some heat. He launches one for the end zone. Oh, my, what a catch. Touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. An 8-play, 76-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. The score now, 31-24. Griffin ready to kick. Tidwell from the two. Tackle at the 31. Illinois is a team that nobody gave a chance today, but they're right where they want to be.
I think just the mindset of this football team, they need to be complimented for that, because it's easy to come in, be a bit intimidated, be a bit overwhelmed. They put that to the side, gone out and executed, and I think the longer they've stayed in this game, the more confidence that it's instilled.
Washington up 7 points. And they get nice yardage on that run. From their own 35-yard line. It's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Let's it fly. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. He goes over 100 yards in receptions.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
the 44-yard line. First down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Throw out to the receiver, and he's tackled at the 29-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 29. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. Wide set. Tackle at the 13-yard line. From the 13-yard line, first down. Washington is up 7. Throws to the receiver, incomplete. We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Here we go. Line check, check.
Makes it to the 12-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Tidwell is the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 9.
Washington is hoping to make this a 2-score game. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Caught at the 8. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on their own 30.
Three down. Mike 51.
Let's go.
Nice catch. First down. He's knocked out.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Taken down at the 45.
That makes it 1st and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Quick throw, incomplete. Wanted his receiver.
Washington, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
The right side, and they make the stop at the 43. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35.
Stop.
pressure coming. He wants it all, going long. And it's caught. And he hits him hard at the two.
That makes it first and goal.
Here they go. First and goal, down by a couple of possessions. Quick tipped. Great play by the safety to keep him out of the end zone.
If he doesn't get a hand in there, that's going to be six. Nice individual effort there by the safety.
And this play is number eight on the drive.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
Brought down at about the 5-yard line.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
Here we go, folks. Third and goal from the four. That's three down and one to go. The Huskies with a 10-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He's tackled around the 3-yard line. It's do or die time right here. Fourth and goal from the three. Here they go on the draw, and they'll lose yards. They don't pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Five wide. He goes downtown. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
From their own 7-yard line, second down. Airing it out long. This one will fall incomplete. Darts it over the middle. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Makes the catch and look out. Tackle made around the 50-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Pick it up, guys. Pick it up. High five.
Here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
On play action. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here. He's pushed out of bounds at the 21. From the 21-yard line, it's first down. Fights forward to about the 20.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Play, and it's first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Fires that quickly, incomplete. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Still 8 yards away. Now it's third and goal. Touchdown, Huskies. Converts the extra point. An 11 play, 93-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
Washington gets set to kick this one away. They'll retreat from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Over the middle to his tailback. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. And they'll lose a yard there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Their own 22-yard line. Second down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five receivers in the formation. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he is drilled at the 26. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Throws complete, but he's going to come up short. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He fights forward to about the 23. Here's the give. They go to the left for a nice gain.
That brings him second and 5.
Second down and 5. Ball on the 18.
It's a party now. It's a party now.
Ready. Red 68. Red 68.
Check, 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 check.
Stingray. Stingray.
Red hot.
Throws a bullet over the middle, and he's hit immediately. From the 11-yard line, first down. Right for a nice game.
That'll make it second and seven.
Let's go.
And he's taken down around the 4-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Washington staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
Well, that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.